We keep running through the green door. I also love it how there's no real load screens between these things. There we go.
Hey there, Acolyte. Hold on a moment. Let me get a look at you. So you're Overseer Tremel's secret weapon. Impressive, to be sure. Afraid the old man waited too long to make his move, though. I'm Vemrin, and unlike you, I've fought and bled for everything I have. I demand respect.
This is a big place, Vemrin. There's more than enough room here for both of us.
I'm glad to hear you say that. There's plenty of room for you behind me. If Overseer Tremel had made his move a year ago when I first arrived, he might have had a chance. But now, too little, too late.
This is ridiculous, Vemrin. Let's just kill him and hide the body.
We're not on Balmora anymore, Torgus. There are rules, traditions. We'll leave the shortcuts to Overseer Tremel and his last pathetic hope here.
You're not very good with people, are you?
You're not funny, just pathetic. And you've been warned. Coming, Dolgus?
Be right there, Vemrin. Listen to me, you useless priss. Acolytes aren't allowed to murder each other. But accidents happen. It isn't murder without witnesses. No more warnings. Vemrin's the alpha monster here. You go after Vemrin, you die.
Such friendly classmates. It reminds me of going back through high school again, or college.
Good. You've returned. You seem to be in one piece. Tell me, how do you like your new blade?
Take a look. I've already blooded it.
What are you doing, Father? I only just got my warblade, and I've been here 6 months.
I have my reasons, Escala. And you will not breathe a word of this to anyone. Do you hear?
Yes. Yes, Father.
Acolyte, this is Escala, my daughter. She's one of the advanced students here. On her way to becoming Sith. If she minds herself.
I'll keep quiet about your new charge, Father. But I won't be there if whatever you're planning blows up in your face.
Don't mind her. She's just sore that I'm keeping secrets. She growls, but she's loyal. Now, I thought I heard Vemrin's voice in the adjacent chamber before you arrived. Did he make his move so soon?
Yeah, I hate him already. I look forward to ending his miserable existence.
If things go well, you will have that satisfaction someday. Still, I'd hoped we'd have more time. Vemrin's not the type to sniff around for too long before trying to take a bite. In a drive for sheer numbers, the criteria for Academy admittance has been relaxed. Now anyone with Force sensitivity is allowed entrance. Vemrin is mixed blood, the invisible rot eating at the foundation of the Empire. He must not be allowed to advance.
So, you're an elitist snob?
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's the Sith way. Only the best, only the most pure, should be good enough.
Unfortunately, Vemrin's caught the eye of Darth Barriss, one of the most influential Sith lords. He's being groomed to be Barriss's new apprentice. As Darth Barriss's apprentice, the power at Vemrin's fingertips will be considerable. He could change the Sith for the worse.
You must proceed to your next trial immediately. I want you to interrogate 3 prisoners in the Academy jails and decide their fates. Consider each criminal's story carefully. The decisions you make will be scrutinized, so let your passions guide your judgments.
Scrutinized? Who presumes to judge my actions? You?
Of course. When Darth Barriss catches wind of you, it's going to be my neck on the line as much as yours.
Go to the Academy prison. Speak to Head Jailer Nash and return to me after you've passed judgment on the prisoners.
One of the things I like about this game is it actually does give you some decent amount of freedom over what your choices are. Like, you're not really limited to being a cruel Sith Lord or a super loyal Republic guy or cheerily naive Jedi. You can really do whatever you want. Like, in my opinion, I like making my Sith warrior. For Sith warrior, I tend to make him sort of a... now I remember what I used to do. This goes up here. There we go. Anyways, for Sith warrior, I used to make him a rich, noble son who basically doesn't like the way that the Empire is being run and wants to make a change, but at the same time, he's still a rather wry comments and kind of rude to everyone, so yeah.
One more chirp from you, little bird, and you'll regret it.
Chirp, chirp, chirp. Ow, jerk! If you don't like that, just say so. I can do other animals, too. Dire cat, frog dog, quaking monkey lizard, you name it.
You, I'm Jayla Nash. I run these cells in slave pits. You're the acolyte Tremel sent for the test, right? He thinks highly of you.
That's good to hear. I want to do well.
You should know this situation is highly unusual. Normally an acolyte goes off well for the interrogation. Overseer Tremel, at these three shipped him for you. He thinks you're the next coming of Exar Kun. But you ought to know, Tremel ain't the only one paying attention to you. Now, these three prisoners have been transferred here for your inspection. You gotta interrogate them as needed, and then decide their fate. The convicted are usually executed or given a trial by combat to see if they're worthy. Whatever you decide, you will be the one to carry out the sentence.
As it should be.
Fine. Let's get started. This one on the left.
You freaks aren't getting anything new out of me. Just do whatever you're gonna do.
You can either talk to me or to the Inquisitors, and I promise I have a much sunnier disposition.
Get lost. I've been through this routine. I already know all your Inquisitors by name.
Impudent to the last. As I was saying, she was sent to kill an Imperial spy in the Yavin system. Throughout her torture, she maintained that she was hired anonymously.
Get it through your damn head! I had no idea he was Imperial, and I don't know who hired me.
So you're telling me you're not a Republic assassin?
I'm not political. I work for whoever pays.
The point is, she doesn't deny the charge. So now you must decide. Execution or trial by combat. Which do you choose?
Neither, actually. She could prove useful. Send her to Imperial Intelligence.
I won't work for free.
You spared her. Interesting.
Please, I am a fellow Sith. Judge me with an open mind and grant me trial by combat, I beg you.
Your name, now.
This part of Waste is Dabotek. Once a valued Sith champion, until he botched an important mission and caused 1,000 Imperial deaths. Now look at him.
I served faithfully for 24 years. Then one mistake, and they threw me away. Now I have been left here to rot. Please, let me feel the weight of a weapon once more.
You're not worth the effort. Live on in shame.
Then I am misery. Languishing here is worse than death.
And I thought his disgrace had already hit rock bottom.
Who knows? With time, maybe he'll rediscover his mettle.
Well, this last prisoner's a bit of a puzzle. He's called Breg, and he's a jittery little wretch, suspected of supplying forged documents to Republic agents. Strangely enough, he maintains his innocence, despite being severely tortured.
Nebaga imama, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamna lebek.
Are you trying to tell me you've led a clean life?
Naki oya makmak. Nebaga imama, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamna lebek.
He's never wavered from that line. and the evidence is circumstantial, I suppose it's actually possible he didn't do it. So, what do you decide?
I think in this case we should release him. Let him go.
Mamni lebek bak manuk. Meraka najaki namabamyak.
Freedom, huh? That's a new one? Ah, well, that's sad. You're an interesting one, kid. I can see why people are keeping tabs on you. Head back to Overseer Tremel. See what he thinks of your choices.
Oh, Tremel's not gonna like me for this. Oh well. I kind of have a habit of making the different overseers not like me. I like to think of it as a gift. A wonderful gift. A wonderful regiment destroying, annoying gift. Do-do-do-do-do. Weird names. Here we go again.
Is this everything?
Everything Lord Renning was able to obtain, yes.
Then run back to your master in the beast pens before I cut you in half. Sorry to make you wait, Acolyte. These interruptions are incredibly annoying. On to the business at hand, your test in the jails. First, the assassin, Solence. She attempted to kill an Imperial spy, but was unaware of her client's affiliation. You assigned her to Imperial Intelligence. I commend you, that was excellent thinking. Never waste a potential resource.
Thank you, Overseer. I'm glad you approve.
What's more important is that Darth Barriss would approve. Now, the failed warrior, Devotech, he begged you to let him die fighting. You left him languishing in his cell. Why?
Why spare him the indignation? Death would only relieve his suffering.
So now we continue to waste resources, housing him. Devotech was an utter waste of space. Once something is no longer useful, it should be eradicated. Remember that. Now, the last prisoner, the Forger. Letting him go was highly questionable. Explain yourself.
Keeping or killing him would be meaningless. Nothing would be gained by either.
Innocent or not, he leaves here with first-hand knowledge of our facilities and procedures. It's potentially compromising to have him floating about the galaxy.
You must always be thinking and considering every angle. Aside from a strong and skilled sword arm, that will be what impresses Darth Barriss the most. You're beginning to understand what it means to be Sith, but you're far from being able to impress Darth Barriss.
I'll try harder, Overseer. I promise.
If you don't, you're doomed. Remember that.
Because I forced you into the Academy ahead of schedule, Darth Barriss will be predisposed to judging you severely. And by severely, I mean fatally.
Now, we must hurry to your next trial. Every moment that passes, we risk discovery before we're ready. In the caverns of Mark Aragnos is the beast he left to guard his legacy. Go there, sit among the flames, and wait for the beast to come for you.
I break beasts' necks in my sleep.
Don't be rash. Defeating this creature will take your best effort. Return to the Valley of the Dark Lords and find the tomb of Mark Aragnos. I'll see you when the beast is slain. Good luck.
Well, I try to be cruel for him, and he just wipes me off. That's just cruel. It's upsetting. Now I've got an ugly shirt. That's not nice. Let's go sell some junk. Let's go sell some junk. Let's go sell. Oh, let's go sell. Oh, look, it was Kemval. La 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 la. Oh, sing a happy song as he chop in half all the little bugs and the little monsters too. Ooh, 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 ooh. Slice and dice and kill them all, kill them all, kill them all. Chop them up into little bits, this is a violent song. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes it is. Oh, do do, oh, get the bind point, do do do, I'll stop this now, la. Okay, anyways, guys, sorry about that. It has been one of those days.
Stand and account for yourself, Acolyte. Let's see what you're made of. I look at you, and I wonder, are you among the truly loyal, or do you hide treason in your heart?
I am heir to a great Sith bloodline. How dare you even ask such a question of me?
I do what the Emperor commands me to. Your special heritage does not place you above suspicion, nor should it. Intelligence reports indicate this valley shelters traitors. Acolytes who seek to destroy our Emperor's carefully built order and replace it with their own weak-minded heresies.
They hide among the faithful and obedient. But make no mistake, they will destroy us all, given the chance.
We've watched as the traitors scuttle about this valley and plot against us. We know their faces and their names. It is the Emperor's will that the sands of Korriban be slaked with the blood of these traitors. Prove your allegiance by executing them.
Are you sure we shouldn't just arrest them? They could be shown the error of their ways.
Treason is a crime with only one punishment, death. If you lack the resolve to uphold the law, that will say much about you.
I'll give you the means to identify the traitors. Eliminate enough of them to prove your loyalty, then return to Inquisitor Arzanen.
I'll be watching your progress with great interest. Go now. See that the Emperor's will be done.
So, let's go kill some innocents, eh? That just sounds very nice. Goodbye, traitor. Well, that's one down. Nope, you live. It's kind of eerie how all these acolytes look identical to each other. I mean, how are we supposed to know their faces and everything like that if they literally are identical? Same clothes, same face, same species. It's kind of freaky, actually. No wonder why they chose to hide with these guys. What was it? Like, how many kids does this family have at all? Seriously. This cannot be healthy. Man, they catch on pretty fast and I know about them. Okay, one more to go. There we go. Okay, we've gone and made a mess of everything in here. Everyone else is a little bit calm, considering that we just sort of slayed everybody. Guess this is just kind of a normal day on Korriban. And you thought your exams were hard.
I watched you deal with those traitors. Well done. That was an impressive display of loyalty. Take this reward as a token of the Emperor's favor. And wear this badge. It marks you as a defender of our empire.
Stay vigilant. Our enemies lurk where you least expect them.
So I have been... I just went out and I got like four enemy acolytes in like a matter of seconds. And they have been staying there with that one guy all this time. And they're going to be staying there for years later on. I'm like... I'm way faster than any of them are. I wonder why they hired me. I'm amazing. I know it. Nice scenery, though. It's kind of interesting as well that when you order a taxi, it means that you get to have a vehicle that... There's another holocron down there. That you get a vehicle that you can drive in. Like, it's not that you don't have... It's not like you have a driver. It's that you're the one who's driving this thing. It's more like a car rental agency, really. How'd I even learn how to drive? Seriously. Lower Wilds. Huzzah. What do you have to say?
Hey, friend. If you're headed out by the Tucata, Lord Varrison is paying actual credits for bone marrow samples. Varrison's doing some sort of experiment for Lord Renning. The less details we know, the better, I'm sure.
Well, that's interesting. You know, bone marrow transplants are actually like the most painful one you can possibly have, so that's gotta hurt.
I've got the best.
Of course, I knew it would kill any of them, so I guess maybe it doesn't hurt, but that's a different matter. Repair all.
Good hunting.
Okay. Running along, running along. And I'll get that holocron later. Right now I got big, tusky, ugly things to kill that are raging on me here. Enraged Takata thing. Wahaha.